October, we had our second existing industry spotlight with the Valdosta Daily Times. Our Made in Valdosta featured Alpha Protech, and so that was in October's monthly spotlight. Here's a copy of screenshot of some of the article. We do have that article framed, and we'll present it to Alpha Protech. They may attend our December meeting, or we may have a board member go with us out to the facility to present them with that. So then Stuart has also met with CRT, Chemical Research and Technology, and that will be our November existing industry spotlight. For community outreach, Mike Beatty, the executive director of Great Promise Partnership, was in Valdosta on Tuesday, October 28th, and there was that was at the city hall, and it was a kind of the kids are ready to be interviewed, and you know we're still kind of getting the ball rolling on the companies interested in participating, and so he came in to kind of highlight that opportunity for our community, and Valdosta Daily Times did a write up on that as well. Last Thursday, we hosted a roundtable with local developers and brokers. We had about five. This was our first meeting. We did a training on our Valdosta Lounge Prospector site, which is our site search with GIS planning. We got some good feedback and dialogue from those that attended. They are definitely want to have continued a luncheon, maybe on a quarterly basis. I actually even had communication with two of them today regarding the prospector site, as well as additional individuals they would like to have be involved in the roundtable. So that was a very successful, and so glad to see us opening our, the community up for to that community.
Excuse me, I had the chance to attend that, and I would just support what you said. They were very enthusiastic. In fact, it went longer than what was planned because they had so many questions and feedback for us also and things we see there.
So we may have, there was a conflict with the Board of Realtors on the last survey, so we may have another one fairly sooner than the first quarter of 2015, just to provide that opportunity as well for those that were not able to attend. We are currently doing a marketing review with Kate McEnroe, and I know Andrea and I both kind of talk and review this, but I wanted to just kind of go over some of the development that we are working on through this is our messaging for in the review, and that being our building a groundbreaking community. What you're looking at here is a conference ad for Area Development Consultant Forum in December that Andrea will be attending. So it's a full page sponsor ad. We kind of did some tweaking to this year as we looked at our messaging on how we want to promote Valdosta and what assets and features our community has that really help us sell and pitch our community. So that's a look at the artwork. This is kind of just some of the bullet points, quick facts about Valdosta that we use for this messaging, being the fast track permitting, which we are also going to have an additional component to of a timeline of the, how to get a business started, business process, or a timeline flow chart of the fast track permitting process. Obviously, we have a great location, but communicating that through, we have 8 exits in Lowndes County off of I-75, and I think when we stopped and counted those, we realized what a strong position that was for the access for distribution. Then also, in the past year, we were featured in Southern Business Magazine as being one of the top 10 locations for the Southern Aerospace Corridor, so we wanted to definitely use that as a message for that target industry. But also has among the lowest property tax rate in Georgia. We have more than 230,000 people within 45-minute drive time, as well as a very young workforce, averaging around 30 years of age, which is 7 years younger than the U.S. average. So those are some of the messagings that we've developed through this process, and we will continue to use and implement as we go through our marketing. And then that's a look again at the artwork. Some additional components we are looking at is a virtual building, similar to your spec building type idea, but this would be virtual. So sitting down and going through the construction timeline and maybe doing some, like a PowerPoint presentation template of pictures of a virtual building being in one of our parks. We're also looking at 2015 marketing activities, our calendar, and so there's some dates that are moving. We'll have that finalized and we can present that marketing calendar of events in December. Also, we are beginning initial discussion regarding Fussell Tire and Bimbo Distribution ribbon cutting in early 2015, so stay tuned. That's all I have for the report.
I've got a couple of questions. Getting back to the Great Promise Partnership, how many businesses do we have who are interested and or signed up for this?
Andrea actually was here that day. I was out of the office.
Ms. Roy?
Actually, Langdale is involved in that one, Langdale Industries, so they've been interviewing. And really the purpose of the meeting was to get more of our business community involved in Great Promise Partnership. So we are looking for more companies, businesses, industries to get involved. It doesn't necessarily have to be manufacturing, logistics, distribution. You know, it can be the City of Valdosta, it could be George Power, it could be Convergys, any range of criminal justice, it could, you know, any of that, that we can get these kids to work and to start going to work every day. We have reached out to some local industries, and I believe B-Lead is looking at participating in this. They see that as being a good opportunity. But I will kind of highlight on Great Promise Partnership. I serve on the Valdosta High Schools or Valdosta City Schools Continuing Education Advisory Committee. Mm-hmm. And I had the opportunity to sit with them and kind of talk through workforce development in our community and kids and how we can really get our businesses and industries more involved in the school system and talking to these kids on a one-on-one basis. And then through Great Promise Partnership was also participating in some mock interviews, which was really interesting and learned a lot from the kids. And it was a great process to go through. So they are already teaching them resume building skills, interviewing skills, and life application to get them ready for when they do go to work. And so they still have to interview just like anybody else would interview for a job. They're just, not because they're in Great Promise Partnership, and they automatically get employed. They still have to interview and be paid as anybody that would be walking in.
If you go back to the previous slide, we're talking about marketing this community. One of the things that, you know, we frequently hear, and this is a common theme, is, you know, we've got to do something about educational opportunities and what kind of students are we producing. I'm sure there's a positive bullet that we can pull out of our educational system. Is there anything that we could find, and I don't think we'll have to scratch too hard, that emphasizes the educational component of this region?
Yeah, through this process, we're looking at the work, how to market our workforce, and so, and that's, we haven't gotten that far into content development and marketing messaging.
This is a work in progress.
Yes.
Still. Okay.
Yes.
All right.
What I would say, in addition to that, though, is one of the things we have been doing is working with Wiregrass Technical College to talk about Wiregrass Georgia Technical College to talk about. The dual enrollment process that they have, and promoting that more. And I know that Megan and Angela Hobby have been working on like a one pager that we can put up on the website as an attachment to kind of show some of the fields that we've got these students graduating in with the dual enrollment. And I will tell you, Lowndes High School also has, I think this is, I said this yesterday to our brokers, or the other day to our brokers, I don't think they realize this. But out of both of our high schools, there's 17 career pathways, and both of them have at least 15 out of the 17 at their high schools, which every student that enters into ninth grade has to enroll in a pathway. And I think some people might not understand that, because that's fairly, over the last few years, something that we've started doing more in the career pathways. But I've recently talked with them, and some of them have got assistant nursing degrees that they can go to work with when they graduate in high school from. So we do have some good stories to tell them, of course, just making sure we get it out there.
Okay. Thank you.
I'd like to make a comment about the existing industry spotlight. operating a business in a small town, my business has been in the newspaper, articles like what you're doing, and I can tell you that it is a very prideful thing for the workers in the business, the managers that work there. It really makes all those people feel good. And if you think about it, there's ordinary things being done in these businesses that people have no idea what you're doing. And then it kind of makes people talk and get an understanding of what you're doing. But it's a wonderful thing for businesses, and I think it's a very good idea.
Thank you. Project report, Mr.